Thank you for joining this video about self-rewarding language models. Just yesterday, Mark Zuckerberg announced that the long-term goal of Meta AI is to build general intelligence and open source it responsibly. So Meta AI is officially working on creating an open source AGI. At the same day, Meta AI released a new research paper titled Self-Rewarding Language Models, which can be a step that takes Meta AI forward in this direction. Pre-trained large language models are being improved by getting feedback about the model outputs from humans, and then train on that feedback. This paper suggests that in order to reach superhuman agents, future models require superhuman feedback. This approach by itself is not completely new, as there are already methods that use large language models to be the ones that provide the feedback, such as reinforcement learning from AI feedback. However, what's novel here is that the model providing the feedback for the model output is actually the same model. In this video, we'll explain the paper to understand how it works. Let's start with the high-level idea, so we know where we're going when we dive deeper into the details. With reinforcement learning from either human feedback or AI feedback, we have a pre-trained large language model, which we use to generate responses. The responses are then evaluated by human or by a different model, in order to produce a dataset of evaluated responses, where each sample is an instruction, a negative response, and a positive response. We then train a reward model based on the data that learned to rank the LLM responses. Then the LLM is trained using the reward model, mostly using PPO, in order to yield outputs with high ranking. More recently, DPO was introduced. In DPO, the need for the reward model is removed, meaning we train the LLM using the feedback data directly, without creating a reward model. With self-rewarding language models, we also have a pre-trained large language model. And the idea is that the LLM can learn to be a reward model for itself. Same as we fine-tune the LLM to follow instruction, here we do both. So the self-rewarding LLM should both learn to follow instruction and act as a reward model. So the LLM is used to generate responses and their evaluation, and then it keeps on training on these evaluated responses. To make it much clearer, we now need to dive into the details of how it is done. But before that, if you enjoyed this content, then please consider subscribing to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. We also send 1-minute read summaries by mail about the papers we review here. You may find the link to join in the description of this video. Okay, so let's move on to explain the self-rewarding language models method in more details now. We start with the pre-trained large language models, referred as M0. And with two initial small datasets. One is an instruction following dataset, which is crafted by humans. This dataset is referred as IFT, shortcut for instruction fine-tuning. The second dataset is referred as EFT, shortcut for evaluation fine-tuning, which contains samples that have an evaluation instruction prompt, which is a prompt that asks the model to evaluate the quality of a given response to a particular instruction. And the second part of the sample is an evaluation result response, which determines the score of the response, with reasoning for the decision. This serves as training data for the LLM to fill the role of a reward model. Then, the first step is to fine-tune the M0 model on these two datasets. The model at the end of this stage is called M1. To understand the remainder of the process, we review the following figure from the paper. The figure describes a self-alignment process that consists of iterations, where each iteration has two phases. The first phase is self-instruction creation. We start with M1, the model we ended after step 1. It is written as empty because it is going to be updated in the next iteration. We use M1, the same LLM, to generate new prompts, as we see on the left. We then generate responses for the generated prompts using M1, the same LLM. We generate multiple responses for each prompt. We then use the same LLM to generate rewards for the responses. The reward values are between 0 to 5. The second phase is called instruction following training. Here, we first create a dataset of preference pairs, where for each prompt we select the responses with the highest and lowest scores as the positive and negative responses. Then, we train M1 model using DPO, which creates M2 model. We can then run another iteration using the M2 model. Let's now move on to see some of the results presented in the paper. The experiments were done when using Llama 2 70B model as the base model, and the two datasets, the IFT and EFT, were crafted from the Open Assistant dataset. The first results we'll see now show that instruction following ability improves with self-training. In the following chart from the paper, we can see three versions of the self-rewarding process, M1 to M3, are compared with the SFT baseline using GPT-4, where the SFT baseline is the base LLM trained with supervised fine-tuning on the instruction fine-tuning dataset only. On the bottom row, we see that M1 and the SFT baseline are on par. However, we see a significant improvement with M2 and M3. And also noticeable is that M3 achieves better results than M2. An important note here is that while we see improvement when getting up to M3, understanding the impact of proceeding to more iteration is still something that should be investigated. Another chart that shows the improvement in instruction following ability compares the results of different versions in the self-rewarding process. And we can see that the more advanced versions wins previous versions of the model. Specifically, in the bottom row, we see a significant gap between the M3 version to M1. Next, we can see results that show the quality of the instruction following ability using the following table from the paper. In this table, we see the win rate over GPT-4 Turbo evaluated using GPT-4. We can see that M3, the third self-rewarding version, achieves win rate of approximately 20%, which is better than various other powerful models, as we can see at the bottom, which is very impressive. Another interesting result shows that the reward model ability is improved in the self-rewarding process. We can see that in the following table from the paper. For example, in the first row, we can see the pairwise accuracy, which is the percentage of times that the order of ranking between any given pair agrees between the model and human rankings. And we can see that the accuracy improves between each version of the model. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more reviews of AI papers.